Pilot ranks in commercial aviation trace their origins to military tradition. Whether you're in the cockpit of a fighter jet or on the flight deck of a commercial airliner, a clear hierarchy is critical for ensuring safety, leadership, and smooth flight operations. In today's video from Epic Flight Academy, we're diving into pilot rankings, how they work, how to tell them apart, and why they matter so much in aviation. Before we start, hit that like button and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more aviation insights. You're cleared for takeoff. Pilot rankings in commercial aviation have evolved from military traditions, creating a clear hierarchy within flight crews. This structure ensures seamless coordination, safety, and efficiency, with each rank carrying specific responsibilities. The ranks, in order of authority, are Captain, Senior First Officer, and Second Officer. Pilots showcase their rank through stripes on their epaulettes, the shoulder decorations on their uniforms. Although the exact system varies by airline, generally, one stripe indicates a second officer or trainee. Two stripes denote a junior or second officer. Three stripes represent a first officer, and four stripes identify the captain, the highest ranking authority in the cockpit. This simple yet effective system reinforces the chain of command for both the crew and the passengers. Uniforms are more than just clothing. They are a powerful symbol of professionalism in the skies. While airlines usually provide the first uniform or offer an allowance for new pilots, it's up to the pilots to purchase and maintain their attire. Did you know the word epaulette comes from the French word for shoulder? It's a small detail, but it highlights how integral uniforms are in aviation culture. Cabin crew members also wear uniforms that reflect their rank and role, blending branding with professionalism to create a polished, unified appearance for the entire team. Back in the early 1900s, pilots didn't have formal uniforms. They wore leather jackets, scarves, gloves, goggles, and boots, often made from military surplus or motorcycle gear to protect themselves from the cold and open cockpits. As commercial aviation grew in the 1920s and 1930s, pilots still wore practical flying gear, but airlines began standardizing their appearance to look more professional. By the 1930s and 1940s, airlines like Pan Am introduced naval-inspired uniforms with gold braid to indicate rank and formal caps with airline insignia, symbols designed to build trust with passengers. The 1950s and 1960s jet age ushered in sharper, sleeker uniforms with standardized epaulettes and winged badges to mark rank and reinforce the glamorous image of pilots. By the 1970s, the look became firmly established. Navy or black suits with gold bars, updated occasionally for comfort and branding. Today, uniforms are made from modern fabrics for better comfort, breathability, and a custom fit, but they still clearly display rank through epaulettes and stripes. When it comes to salary, seniority often plays a key role, but factors like aircraft type and regional location can also affect earnings. Pay varies across ranks and airlines. Captains typically earn the highest salaries, followed by senior first officers, and second officers. At Epic Flight Academy and many other flight schools, stripes symbolize a student pilot's progress and achievements. All Epic students start with a standard black and white uniform, creating a professional image from the start. When a student completes their first solo flight, they're awarded wings to proudly pin to their shirt, a huge milestone. From there, stripes are earned with each check ride passed. One stripe for a private pilot license, two stripes for an instrument rating, three stripes for a commercial pilot license, and four stripes for becoming a certified flight instructor. While every student's journey is unique, the typical timeline at Epic is about 3 months to earn the private pilot license, 2 months for the instrument rating, two more months for the commercial single engine license, and another 2 months for the certified flight instructor program. Each stripe marks a significant step forward on a pilot's training and career development. While airline ranks share military influences, they differ in important ways. In the military, rank progression depends on combat experience, leadership skills, and time served. In contrast, airlines base their rankings on flight hours, simulator performance, certifications, and seniority. Rankings can also vary based on aircraft type or regional aviation standards. The U.S. military operates a much more complex structure, with 37 distinct ranks across all branches. These are split into enlisted, warrant officers, and commissioned officers, with epaulettes used to mark rank since the 17th century. Even figures like General George Washington wore epaulettes to signify leadership during the American Revolution. So, why does rank matter in commercial aviation? Rank defines authority, streamlines communication, and keeps operations running smoothly. In an emergency, there is no time for confusion. Everyone from the cockpit crew to the cabin staff must know their roles and follow clear lines of command. This system isn't just about tradition. It's about ensuring safety, clarity, and teamwork every time a plane takes off. That's everything you need to know about pilot rankings. We hope this video helped shed light on the importance of rankings in aviation and how military tradition has shaped this crucial hierarchy. If you found this video useful, give it a like. Then subscribe to our YouTube channel for more aviation content from Epic Flight Academy.